Hi, so today we'll find out about the chi-square test and how it is used to find out whether two given variables are related or not. Okay. Now, first of all, we need to find out what is our aim, why are we using the test. So that can be stated like this. Suppose that this particular question, okay, you can look at this table. In this table, we have two variables. One represents the education qualification of a person and the other represents the marital status of a person, whether he is unmarried, married, divorced or widowed. Okay. Now, what our aim is? Our aim is to calculate or state whether the two variables, the education qualification and the marital status, are these related to each other or they have no relation with each other. One or the other thing. Okay. So, first of all, we start with defining our null hypothesis and the alternate hypothesis. Our null hypothesis can be stated that there is no correlation between the two variables, and the alternate hypothesis can be stated by saying that there is significant relation between the two variables. Okay. Now, significant. The significance level is to be defined. The significant level, either it can be taken as 0.05, which is 5% deviation from the mean, or we can say 0.01. Usually the significance level is taken as 0.05. Okay, there are different significance levels taken for different type of observations, but generally the significance level is taken as 5%, that is 0.05. okay, so we'll go with that. Okay, now how to start? Now, first of all, we'll look at the observation values, the values which are observed or which have been taken from the field. So these are called as observed values. Now, we'll prepare another table for the same variables, but those values will be calculated values, or you can say the expected values. Now, how to calculate it? Now, in this table, you can see there are 36 people who are unmarried and whose education is high school. Right. Now, for those people, the expected value could be the row total into the column total divided by the grand total. There are 300 people whose data has been collected. So, that is called as the grand total. Okay. So, that comes out to be 27. Okay. In the same way, for the first element, that is 18. There are 18 people who are unmarried and whose education is middle school. The expected value will be 90 into 39 divided by 300. That will give you 11.7. In the same way, we need to calculate the expected value for all the categories, and the table which will get like this. This will be the table for the expected values, and the first one was the table for the observed values. Now, our aim is to find out how much deviation is there between the two given values. Okay, that is found out by a simple formula, that is observed minus the expected value, the whole square upon the expected value. So, we prepare another table which states the difference between the two variables. Which states the difference between the two values. Okay. Now, we'll look at this table now. Here you can see the table contains different values. The table contains the observed value, the expected value, the difference between the two values, the square of the difference between the two values, and divided by the expected value. So, we'll fill out this table. The first value there was 18, and the observed value was 18, the expected value was 11.7. So, 18, 11.7, the difference, the square, and we divide it by the expected value, that is 11.7. What I get is 39.69, and once I divide it by E, I get as 3.39. Now, in the same way, we need to calculate all the given values, the difference between the expected and the observed values. And I get this table completed, and once I complete this table, you can see the total of this last column, that is the observed value minus the expected value, the whole square upon the expected value. This value is called as the value of the chi-square. Okay. Now, this value is the calculated chi-square. we also need to compare this value with the tabular value of chi-square. Now, how is that calculated? Now, for tabular value, I need to find out the degrees of freedom. Now, degrees of freedom is found out by a simple way. You can see in the original question, there were 5 columns, 5 different categories for the level of education, and there were 4 different categories for the marital status. So, the degrees of freedom is calculated by 5 minus 1 into 4 minus 1. That comes out to be 12. Okay. So, 12, we need to see the table for the, this table for the tabular value of chi-square, and we can see the tabular value of chi-square for the degrees of freedom, that is 12, and the significance level 0.05. That comes out to be 21.03. Right. Now, once we get this value, we can compare the calculated value and the observed value. We can see the tabular value is smaller than the calculated value. So, in chi-square, whenever the calculated value is greater than the tabular value or the critical value, then we can state that our null hypothesis is rejected and the alternate hypothesis is accepted. Now, what was our alternate hypothesis? It was that there is a significance relation between the two variables, between the marital status and the level of education. So, this is how we use the chi-square test to state whether the two variables are related or not.